Welcome to drycalcool.com. In this video, we'll discuss about how to create workflow in Jira. So when we talk about the workflow, all Jira projects contain issues that our team can view, work on, and transition through stages of work from creation to completion. The path that our issue takes is called workflow. Each Jira workflow is composed of a set of stages and transitions that our issue moves through during its life cycle and typically represents work processes within our organization. In addition, Jira uses workflow schemes to define the relationship between issue types and workflow. Workflow schemes are associated with a project and make it possible to use a different workflow for different combination of project and issue types. If you need to edit or create a more advanced workflow to match how our team or organizations work, we can log into Jira Administrator and with global permissions to access, and we can create our workflow. For creating a workflow, it's mandatory requirement. We need to have administrator login credentials. From here, once you will navigate into the project, select on the settings, and from the settings, click on issues. Here you'll find it out the workflow. These are the workflow which is associated with our project line items. If you want to create a new workflow, you can create it from here. Otherwise, if you want to edit our existing workflow, we can edit it from here. Select any particular workflow and we can see either in diagram or text view. Click on this diagram and you can see this is a nicely created workflow. We can edit it accordingly. If you want to create a new workflow, better we can click on this add workflow, click on create a new workflow. For creating a new workflow, we have to define the name of the workflow. So right now I am giving as a sample workflow. Now in descriptions, I will add the descriptions about this workflow, why I'm using. So this is, I'm creating for the demo point of view. Click on add and this workflow diagram will generate. So here for creating a workflow, we'll get two faces or two view. Either we can view through a diagram or we can also see via text. So for adding a new stages, we will click on new steps and add the link status and click on add, and that label will be added for us. Right now I'm more convenient and comfortable with the diagram view, so that I'm selecting diagram view. And most important part, if you're visiting this channel for the first time and you want to learn about Jira, please hit subscribe button so that whenever I will upload the related video, you will get notified immediately. And I will also include the complete playlist about Jira. You can have a look and go through about all the Jira contents. Approximately, I've created more than 50 videos till now on Jira itself. Now, when you want to create or add new stages, let's consider one example here. So in current status, let's say your team is following only 4 stages. Let's consider new for defect creating. I'm talking about just for defect or bug. For defect creations, if they are using only 4 stages, let's consider new, or miserly they are using by default view, that is open, assign, then fixed, and finally closed. Now these are the only 4 stages used by your current scenario. But if in any projects you want customizations, in that case, simply you need to create a workflow from beginning. And always keep in mind, whenever we are creating a workflow, don't use any stage and change their name. So if you are changing the name, that will impact to other projects as well. So rather than the changing name, you can create by your own. So here what I will do, I will create a new state. state for defect or bug. In this scenario, by default scenario, we are using just four stages. Here, let me add new, then we have assign, or maybe we will add analysis. Analysis, then next step, we'll add here assign to dev, then in progress, they will mark as in progress, then this, they will mark as fixed and assigned to the QA team. Once the QA team validated, they will add validation here. And further, after validations, they will again assign to the project manager for done, and post that they will close it. So now let's consider these are the workflow which we will follow it, and post creating we'll assign it to the defect and see how the workflow will looks like. So let's add a new state. So right now I don't want this open, let's keep that open only. Add a status like analysis. Right now you already have the analysis. If you want, you can select from the existing stages, that doesn't matter. Click on add. I am giving here as an analysis, that is first step. Next, I want assign to dev. It means in development we already have this status, so I will select and add it. Next, I want next state will be in progress, so definitely we'll have the new status in progress. In progress we have here, click on add. Next, I want fixed validation done and closed. Let's select fixed. Do we have fixed? Yes, we have fixed. Sometime if the field is not available, just write down the name and here like this and click on add new status will be added successfully. If you will select this checkbox, this will allocate all status to that field. Now post fixed, we want a new field like validation done and closed. So we might have validation. We don't have validation, so we'll add validation here. Validation as a new status, click on add, and here we are defining the name. Right now we are keeping in progress. Now we want to move it to the next. Now here we added validation. Next I want done. Done. We have not added done. Selected done, then closed. So we'll select this field and click on close. Now we have added all the stages. Now the next field will be adding transitions. So transition will show how workflow will go one by one, and even we can also add reject field. So rejected. Let's consider here we are having after analysis. If analysis team found this is not a defect, they will immediately reject it and assign it back to the person who has raised this defect. Let's add transitions here. Reject to open. Open so that rejected. Or we will call it here return back. So if you can see here, the name is highlighted here, return back to the open status. Now, next transitions, I want to add from analysis to rejected. I'll mark as a name reject. Click on add and you can see this transitions have been added. Next, I want to add analysis. If that successfully passed, it means analysis team found this is a valid defect. Then they will mark it to pass and send it to the development team. So from analysis to development, it means I'm giving as a pass, analysis pass. Click here. Now you can see text is highlighted with the pass. Next field will be development to in progress. So here, what I will do, development to in progress. And in this field, dev started working. Click on add and you can see here, this field will be added. Next one is in progress to fixed. So here, I will select this and this one and complete it. You can see this is completed. Post fix, QA team will start working into it. Next, fix to validation and the name will be QA. Once the validation will be done, they will again assign to the project manager to close this effect. Validations to done. Next step. Add, and you can see next step added. And the finally, we are marking as from done to closed. So that project manager will close that issue. Here we are done and you can see the complete workflow will be generated. If you can see in the text view, you can see all this graph will be generated. If you want to delete any transitions, you can delete it. If you want to add any specific transitions, you can add it. Editing is possible. If you want to see the view properties, you can also have a look about property sections. Now here, unless and until we'll not assign this workflow to any particular scheme, that will always into the inactive status. So here, this is a workflow which we have created. Finally, we have to assign this workflow to any issue types. Right now you can see these are the assignment. If we want to add it, click on add it and remove this. Now we want to add one more workflow. For adding new workflow, click on add existing and scroll down at the end. Might be we have simple workflow. I think it's simple base of workflow. Yeah, this one. And you can see it's exactly same workflow which we have created. Click on next. On which screen we want to assign it. Right now I'm selecting bug and task. So whenever I will create a bug and task, this workflow will be appear. Click on finish, and post clicking on finish until and unless will not mark as published, this will still be in the draft mode. And whenever I will create issue, I won't be able to see that workflow which we have created. So make it public or published. It will take some time. Click on associate, and within few seconds this workflow will be allocated to our defect and task. Just click on acknowledge. Now this workflow will be assigned to our defect. Let's create one defect and see is it really this workflow is assigned or not. Now let's just add test demo workflow. Click on create. View issue ES32. Go here, view workflow, and you can see exactly same workflow is assigned to my defect. So unless and until these all steps will be not there, we won't be able to complete that defect. So that's how we'll create and assign the workflow in Jira. Hope you enjoyed this video. If you think so, this will be useful. Don't forget to share within your circle. Thank you for watching.